Link, backlinks, and to some extent, a graph view are some of the advantages of a digital personal knowledge management app over a paper or analog one. Having said that, Anytype has released the first iteration of some of the most useful and functional features that a digital knowledge management app can have, at least in my opinion. And I am very excited to share them with you. So without further delay, let's start. Now, we know that Anytype is an app that is stored locally, but it syncs device to device with the help of Anytype's very own AnySync protocol. Anytype has already released its repositories, so those who can self-host can do so. But for that, we have to know our way around coding, but not anymore. This is Anytype's very own one-click local only or one-click self-hosting option. For that, I have to first log out of my Anytype. For that, I'm going to this spaces or account button, click it, and here are my different spaces. And I'm going to go to this gear button, click, and here I have the logout option. Here I'm going to see my recovery phrase. I'm going to backup phrase. It will just copy to the clipboard, and then I'm going to log out. Now be careful. After we click the backup phrase option, this phrase is going to become visible. So in order to keep our space private or account private, it is better if there is no one around when we're backing up this phrase. Now I'm going to click log out. And we have come back to the login page. To access our local only or self-hosting option, I'm going to click this gear button, and this is going to give us two options of interface language and the network. We're going to click this drop-down menu beside the network option, and we see there are three options: Anytype, local only, and self-hosted. Anytype syncs our data with the AnySync protocol, and our media are synced by the synced block of Anytype. And this local only will sever all our network connections, and all our Anytype files will be only stored in our device. Here, and that's it. And then we go to the self-hosted mode. Here we just upload our self-hosting configurations, and that will make sure that Anytype is syncing via our network of choice rather than Anytype. I'm not going to use this. I'm going to keep using Anytype's AnySync protocol. So I'm going to click this and hit save. And that's it. Now I'm just going to log into my account again. Login. And I'm going to click Control V on my keyboard to paste the recovery phrase. And then click login. So this was the first new feature that I wanted to talk about. This feature is keeping with Anytype's commitment to data ownership. Now, the second option has more to do with linking our thoughts. For that, I'm going to go to my test space by clicking here. And I'm going to go to the graph and open one of the objects. Here I go. This is just me. Web novel that I was linking. Here we can see that in this featured relations here, there is this two links option. Before, the only way to see the objects connected to another object was to go to the flow option. For that, we can go to this graph view, then go to this flow view. We also can access the flow by hitting the shortcut Control O. And here we can see all the objects that are connected to this My Dear Esther object. I'm going to go to this object, and we can now see the backlinks from the object itself. If we hover over this and click it, we can see that it is connected to these two objects. But the interesting thing is this is actually a relation. So if we go to the place where relations are inside an object, which is this three dots pyramid menu, we can see that this links to this object relation has these two relations here. Now, if we don't want this relation to show up as featured just below the title of our object, then what we have to do is just click this star button. And when this star button is no longer highlighted in yellow, then this will not be shown here. But I like to have an overview of all the connection that an object has. So I'm just going to keep this featured. There we go. Now, while we are at it, I would also like to mention that the template feature has also undergone some changes. For this, I'm just going to create a new object here. Now, this is Note because I had chosen the default object type to be Note by going to the Space option and then going to this Default Object Type option and choosing Note. We can choose any other type as our default type, but I'm just going to keep it as Note, clicking out of here. Now, if you click here, we can change the type as well. If I change the type to any other of the types, here we can see a pop-up saying that this type has 5 templates. I'm going to click it and it gives us a small preview of all the templates that are available here. If I just click one and it applies the template. But as you can see, this pop-up has not disappeared. Even if I change the title of this object, it still will not disappear. This means that we can still change the template of this object. As you can see, or say this one. But if we start typing inside the object, and as you can see, as soon as I have started typing within the object, the template option has disappeared. So this means that as long as we do not write inside the object, we can keep changing the template of our object. But there is still no way to change the template of a modified and formatted object. But Anytype team are trying to make that happen. Now, the next feature that I want to talk about is a feature that I like very much. To demonstrate it better, I'm just going to go to the space that I usually use. Here we are. Here is the graph view. And what I'm going to do is go to this graph settings option and turn on this last option, which is the local graph. Here I go. And as I can see, all the things have disappeared. So all I have to do now is open one object. Here I have opened an object. Now from here, if I go to the graph view, I can only see which object this particular chosen object is connected to. Let's see another one. Here we go. This is a collection. Let's go to the graph. And here we can just see that particular connection. From here, we can go to one of the objects. And as you can see, it's just showing the relations of that one object. Now, if we now want to see all the other relations that it is connected to, then we can go back to the graph settings and turn off this local graph option. And all the other connections have returned. And we can still find our object because it is highlighted in yellow like this. I also hope that Anytype will implement a system where first level of connection, second level of connection, third level of connection will be visible in phases. But currently I am happy with the local graph. And now the next and this year's last feature that I want to talk about is one that I find highly useful. Now, what I'm going to do to demonstrate this feature is go into one of my objects. First, let's go into the collection. Then I'm going to go to this object. It is an object that I use to make one of my videos, making it full screen. Now what I'm going to do to demonstrate this new feature is that bring the cursor here, then click forward slash, then type E-M-B-E-D, embeds. And as you can see, Anytype now supports embeds from a lot of sites. Like first is LaTeX, then Mermaid and Charts, and YouTube and Vimeo videos, projects from SoundCloud, and also Google Maps. And the last is Miro boards. So if we have many mind maps scattered throughout, we can use this feature to add them to our Anytype and have all our knowledge in the same place. And if you're like me and use YouTube to augment parts of your knowledge, then this is going to be very useful, as it has been very useful to me. I'm just going to demonstrate this feature by clicking the YouTube icon and embedding a YouTube video. As you can see, typing forward slash, then embeds, and then clicking the YouTube button brings us this input box. I had already copied a link of one of my videos from my YouTube channel, and I'm going to paste it here by clicking Ctrl V on the keyboard. And here we have the video. And we can tell from the blinking cursor that here is an option to change the link and change it into another video. If we click outside of this video, if we click the play button, here we go. Now, if we want to edit this and change this video to another one, what we have to do is hover over the video and we get a pencil icon here. If we click it, we can get back this link with the cursor hovering, and we can delete it and change it into another link. And if we want to delete this video, what we have to do is go to this pencil icon here and then right click. Right clicking will bring us this menu, and if we click delete here, it will delete this video. I'm just going to bring this video back. This was the last feature of this year. I hope you had a happy Christmas and wishing you a happy new year. I hope this has been useful to you, and I hope my future videos will be useful to you as well. Have a good day. See you soon.